Hello friends, let us see International System of Numeration today. See the chart given here. Any 9-digit number you can write using this International System of Numeration chart. In this system also each period is separated by a comma. So when we move from right to left, after each 3-digit we have to insert a comma. Here observe the chart. Ones period is a combination of ones, tens and hundred. Thousands period is a combination of 3-digit, that is 1000, 10,000, 100,000. Millions period is a combination of million, 10 million and 100 million. If we compare with the Indian system of numeration chart, then you can see clearly that ones, tens, hundreds, thousand, 10,000, it is one and the same. As soon as we go with the higher place, we observe that 1 lakh is same as 100,000. Similarly, 1 million is equal to 10 lakh. 10 million is 1 crore. 100 million is 10 crore. Many a times you are asked a question that 1 million is how many lakhs. So here you can see clearly that 1 million is 10 lakh. We will see few of the questions where you have to write the number name, numeral for the given number name. Fine. Now let us see first question. Say here, 1,286,475. Now, as you know, the number starts with million. So I have to write the comma. Here 3 digits. Let us write the places over here. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousand, 10,000, 100,000, million, 10 million and 100 million. This is 1 million. So in 1 million, how to write 1 million in 3 digits, that is 001 or simply 1. How many thousands are there? 286,000. So 286,000. 475. So 475. Let's go with another example. 49,006,582. Again you can see the word given as million. So 3 digits, 3 digits, 3 digits. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousand, 10,000, 100,000, million, 10 million, 100 million. 49 million. 49, how to write in 3 digits, that is 049 or 49. So 49,006,000, this is only 6,000. How to write 1000 in 3 digits? So that is 006. 582. So 582. Let's go with another example. 3,41,25,680. Do you find million over here? No. So the word given here is crore. So you have to use Indian system of numeration, right? Now when you have to write Indian system of numeration, when you have crore, you know that how many commas you were writing. So three commas, after the last comma, three digits, two digits, two digits, two digits. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousand, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh, crore and 10 crore. Now this is 3 crore. So how to write 3 in two digits? That is 0, 3 or 3. 41 lakh. So in lakhs place 41, 4, 1. 25,000. So 25 in thousands place. 680. So 680. Now, still, if we move further, then sometimes you are asked to write the estimate. So, when you have to estimate the sum or the difference, product, or you have to find the quotient, then sometimes possibly you are asked with the condition given. That is, estimate each difference or estimate each sum to the nearest tens or to the nearest hundreds or to the nearest thousands. Here the condition given is nearest tens. So you have to apply this condition only. When it is asked using general rule, then you have to round off each factor to the greatest place. How will you do it? We will see here. So here, let's go with the first example. Nearest tens. So 53, when you have to round off to the nearest tens, that is, you know that in tens how many zeros are there? 10, one digit underlined. The underlined digit should be greater than or equal to 5. Here it is not so, so 5 remains 5 only. Now 18, when you round off to the nearest tens, one digit 0, 8 is greater than 5. So 1 we need to add to the previous number, that is 1 plus 1, that is 2. Now go for the subtraction. So here 50 minus 20, that is 30. If 409, you have to round off to the nearest tens, then one digit underline 10, 9 is greater than 5. So 40 plus 1, that is 41. Then we go with 148. When we have to round off to the nearest 10, one digit underline 10, and 8 is greater than 5, so 14 plus 1, that is 15, and now go with the subtraction part. So here 0, here you will have 11, minus 5, that is 6, and 3 minus 1, that is 2. Now here, you have to estimate the sum to the nearest hundreds. So nearest hundred. So we will round off the numbers to the nearest hundreds. So 458, when we round off to the nearest hundreds, in hundreds two zeros are there. So two zeros I will write. The digit at the higher place is 5. So condition is satisfied. One we have to add to the previous number, that is 4 plus 1, 5. Then the other number is 324. When we round off to the nearest hundreds, so two zeros you need to write first, then two is at the higher place, which is not greater than 5, so three remains as it is, and now add them, so you have 0, 0, 5 and 3, 8. Now let's go with the another example. When we round off to the nearest hundreds, two digits 0, the place, the digit at the higher place is 8. Condition satisfied. 100 plus 1 is 101. 29380. What will it be? 00. Condition satisfied. 293 plus 1. 294. And now add them. But when you have the question as estimate the product using general rule. Now when I say general rule, it means you have to round off each factor to the greatest place. So if the number is two digit, you will round off to the nearest hundreds. If it is 3-digit, you will round off to the nearest hundreds. If it is 4-digit, you will round off to the nearest thousands. Let's see here. 64 is a 2-digit number. So we will round off the number to the highest place. That is, this is 1's place. This is 10's. So we will round off the number to the nearest 10's. So 1-digit 0, 4 condition is not satisfied. So 6 remains as it is. 38 when we round off to the nearest 10's. So 1-digit is 0, condition satisfied. So 3 plus 1, 4, and then multiply. So 2 zeros and 6 4s are 24. Let's go with the second example, 409. This is 1's place, 10's place and 100's place. So we will round off the number to the nearest 100's. In 100's, 2 zeros, the digit at the higher place is 0. Condition not satisfied, so 5 remains as it is. 179, also 3-digit number. We will round off to the nearest 100's. So 2 zeros and 7 is at the higher place. So 7, we will add 1 to the previous number. So 1 plus 1, that is 2. And now multiply. So here you will have 4 zeros and 5 twos are 10. Let's see the quotient. 725. Again, the number is in hundreds. So we will round off to the nearest hundreds. 2 zeros. The digit at the higher place is 2. Condition is not satisfied, so 7 remains as it is. Now 23 is a 2-digit number. We will round off to the nearest tens. So here 1-digit is 0 and condition not satisfied, so 2 remains as it is. Now this is division, so we will divide the numbers. So here you can see that 0 will go away. 70 divided by 2, that is 35. Let's go with the next question. Say 633. We will round off to the nearest hundreds. 2 digits underline. The digit at the higher place is 3. Condition is not satisfied, so 6 remains as 6 only. 33 is a 2-digit number. We will round off to the nearest tens. Condition not satisfied, 3 remains as it is. And it's division. So 0 will go away. 60 divided by 3, that is 20. Hope you are clear. Thank you.